Hello. In this screencast, we will go over the steps needed to install Amahi via the Express Disk release. This install method is a headless install, which means a monitor is not required once the system is up and running. Most Amahi users install on a hardware system, but we will be installing on a virtual machine for the screencast. To get Amahi running, you will need to download Amahi and burn it to a disk, install and customize the operating system, and then initialize Amahi and complete the install. To start the installation, boot your system from the Amahi disk you downloaded. Once the system is up and running, you will be first prompted to set up the language. After that, you should configure the date and time settings. At this stage, please do take time to review the storage settings to match the destination where you want the operating system to be installed. It's very important to understand that in the Express Disk installation, the first available drive will be completely erased unless you change the default storage settings. Once all your settings are as you want, click on Begin Installation. While it installs, please create a user with a full name, a username, and a password. The last two are case sensitive, so please make a note of them. Make the user an administrator by checking their corresponding box so that there's no need to set up a root password. The operating system installation may be quick or may take some time depending on the speed of your hardware. Near the end of the install, you will be prompted to enter the install code for this system. You should have an Amahi install code for this system from your registration at the Amahi website. Make sure the networking settings you previously set in this system in the Amahi control panel match what you have in your network. This is a common source of installation problems. You can delete a profile on the website and start a new profile with the settings that you want at any time. After the install is done, click on Reboot. The operating system should then boot from the hard drive to a text console. At this point, the system will fully configure Amahi in the background. So let it sit there for a few minutes. It should reboot by itself one last time, and when it reboots, it will come up with the static IP address that you set it up in the Amahi website. Again, it will reboot by itself one last time. Now, once the system is up and running, Amahi should be ready to serve your network. At this point, we strongly recommend, for best operation, that you turn off the other DHCP server in the network, that's typically in the router. Then reboot all the systems in your network so that they get their network settings from your newly installed Amahi server. Once you have a client with an Amahi provided network setting, open an internet browser from the client and type http://hda in the URL box. This should bring you to an initialization webpage for your system. If this does not work, you could try the IP address of your system to get to the initialization page. But this may mean that your client device does not have the network settings from Amahi yet. This page will ask you to enter a username, a password, and a confirmation. Make sure you set the same capitalization here that you used in the earlier setup. Then you will be directed to your very own Amahi dashboard, where you can set up the users of your network, configure your shares, and add apps. We will look into that in another screencast. Thanks for watching.